Hello and welcome to the second part of the Open Journey. For those who did not watch the Open Journey yet, it is a collection of different open source games I discovered and I would like to present to you. And today we're gonna talk about Tesseract. Tesseract is a fork of the Cube 2 engine and mostly focusing on modern graphic. It was also made by a few guys from the original Cube 2 development team. Game mechanics. The game mechanics themselves do not bring new features to the engine or the game. It has basically two game modes, Insta-Gib and Capture the Flag. Also, it does only feature two types of weapons, no ammunition and no collectible items. And in each game mode you can set with which weapon each player would spawn. So you need not to collect one of those weapons, you always have this weapon and has infinite amount of ammunition, and yeah, if you hit once you always dead. So basically the Insta-Gib mode is always on, even in the Capture the Flag game mode. Further on, there is the well-known Cube 2 in-game editor. Technical. Tesseract is based on the Cube 2 engine, as I already mentioned, and is extending it with many graphical features such as volumetric lighting, ambient occlusion, global illumination, screen space reflections, and some more. And a few minor changes to the in-game editor, which features a more advanced map object placement, so you can rotate them around two axes. That's everything I was able to find out currently. Maybe you know more. Yeah, the current version seems to be the first edition from May 11th, 2014. But there are also nightly builds which seems not to include any further changes to the game, and also seems to be made by an automatic build system because the file size did not really change from version to version. So I think there is an automatic system behind that one. But there are some community forks as well, such as Rivalry 3D Engine, Nova Fight, and Adrenaline Cube 2. Currently, I was not able to find one of these three forks, so I'm not pretty sure if they really exist or if they are really continued. Well, the development of Tesseract itself seems not to be continued, it seems to be discontinued. Background, I wasn't able to find out any special background such as, hey, let's make some modern graphics with Cube 2. Yeah. The rating. I would give Tesseract about 3 stars because it has an awesome graphics. The performance is also, mwah, it runs like a charm. But the negative points are there's nearly no content, only 3-5 maps, I'm not quite sure, and yeah, it seems not to be developed any longer. Yeah, for those of you who are curious about Tesseract, our links are in the description, and that's for today's part. See you next time, bye bye!